then watching it play out on yesterday's episode, I was a blubbering mess. Did you see yesterday?
I did, yeah. It was heartbreaking. It was heartbreaking to film, even though I knew I'd see him again, but I guess it's just in that format, you know?
How are you feeling now?
I love your, also that moment when you and John are finally together, and then he, you guys are like, why didn't we get together before? Because we're idiots, because we're stubborn. That, I loved that.
Wasn't that great?
It was great. It really was. I was really impressed. You know, it's so funny because, you know, we didn't always have the entire story of what was going on, just kind of what you're doing, and to see everything together and how everything played out with the fraternity row, and it was really, I just thought it was lovely how Ron put all of this together. It was really kind of cool because it just made you feel like, you know, everybody, including the characters, are going through the same thing as well as the fans.
And exactly, he said that to me on the interview I did with him on Wednesday that I posted today, and I wanted that to be the final interview. I thought Ron should have the final word, right?
Yeah.
And it was a lovely interview, and he said the exact same thing that you just said, that we all went through this together, that the fans, mm-hmm. the characters, and what I say, Melissa, is what beautiful writing, and what an homage to the audience. I mean, this was a time when the writer of a show really cared about his audience. You know, they cared all the way through the end. It wasn't like, well, we're off the air, we're just gonna finish up. Let's just get out of this. You know, there was a detail put to it. Was there something that you were most proud of at the last, you know, your last moments, the last several weeks? Is there something you were, like, really thrilled to get to do other than, of course, reunite with John?
Well, I have to say, all the stuff with Mitch was a blast. Like, it was, you know, to shoot a gun, to, you know, fight scenes. I mean, it was kind of like all the things I like to do all in one. It was really fun.
And you plugged them, and you shot them.
I know.
All right, Melissa, well, we have some callers who want to talk to you, so let's pick up on 832. What's your name? Where are you checking in from?
Houston, Texas. My name's Brittaney.
Hey, Brittaney.
Hi, Brittaney.
Hey, Brittaney.
I'm Melissa.
Is this Brittaney P by chance?
Yes, it sure is.
How are you?
I am fantastic now that I get to talk to you.
You too.
What,
you got a question for me?
Yeah.
You know, I would love to ask a lot of questions, but I know we're limited on time here. I just have to say, I've been a fan of yours since you were pretty much were on Wishbone, and I grew up watching you as a kid, and What a Life to Live, and I pretty much loved all your storylines, and I was just wondering, like, I know you love fight scenes, but, like, what was your favorite fight scene you've done over the last 10 years?
Oh, wow, that's a tough
that's
one. Because they were all really fun. Of course, the Carriage House one with Aaron Torpy was pretty awesome. That was also lots of fun because there was lots of throwing things, you know, that was always cool. The one with Mitch actually was really neat too. Just I liked the choreography in it, and it just seemed to continue for days. and then of course the one with Bree was really fun. That was a blast. I don't know. I think they're all a lot of fun. I don't
Even
know that I have
Melissa
a favorite.
Melissa's the slugger of the show. She goes through everything.
Yeah.
So they're all really fun.
Yes.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for your call, Brittaney.
You're welcome. Bye, Melissa.